Hello everybody, I'm going to kind of give you guys some stuff on my YouTube channel, a little something we're going to kind of show you. As many of you know, I've been getting a program that I've been working on for the last several months is to doing a lot of my thumbnails that I've been doing on this channel, and I'm still learning it. I have Photoshop, and let's just kind of give you guys a little bit about Photoshop and how everything goes through. If you guys look at this particular one, this is my car mechanic simulator one. Okay, so if you look right here, you notice right here, this is a segment. So for an example, tomorrow's video, it's quite easy. I put in that number 4, I hit file, and I hit save. But let's say we want to design something, okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually import something into something. We're going to design something from scratch, just to design to you guys exactly what we've got. We got some stuff that's already been made. Okay. I like a good blank template here to kind of to show you guys some of the behind the scenes stuff. Let's take this one. Okay, I can turn around and create a blank template on it. And I've got a lot of pre-made templates, by the way, just so you guys know. Let's take a regular image. Hold on. I want a fresh template that I can work at, and as you can probably tell, I have a lot of different templates. Let's do one. Let's just make up one. Okay. Oh, this is a Photoshop. This isn't. So we're creating a template, and this is one of my templates that I've used before. So let's close off our previous one. Hold on, where's my tool menu? There it is. Tool menu is off the screen. Bring it to a menu right here. So let's just click this. Let's drop that background. And select a new layer. Hit OK. Another way of doing things, if something fails, always take those opacities, like I said, clear. Oh, that is not it. Hard. Let's put that at 1,000. So we have a totally black background altogether. That's the easiest way of doing it. Leave that on. I have a picture that I want to use. This picture. Copy. Oh, and by the way, you want to use, and by the way, we're going to do something here. Let me go ahead and hit File, Save As. We're going to put this as an example. I'm also going to put in a program, and the whole thing is that with PaintShop Pro, I kind of struggle with some things when it comes down to it, because like I said, this is something that I normally don't do. We're going to have to close. Let's export this as a PNG file. And close that off. There's a reason. You'll see in a minute. Let's grab paint.net. A little secret. We'll keep that canvas size. We're going to take this image. Wait a minute. Hold on. I screwed up. Just gonna off that. Don't save. Use that. Keep the canvas. No, it's not save snowing. It's save. Okay. And close. File open. We want to go ahead and so this get let's say for example I want to do a thumbnail or something like that. When I want to minimize the thumbnail, okay, I don't know how to do the thumbnail in PaintShop Pro yet. I'm still learning how to do that. Okay. Now, if you click over here, you'll see I got this thing over here on the side here. So we got these little text buttons. And I want, I got a lot of different choices that we can do. In this case, I'm creating just a good example of something. Okay, let's change the size. size was really important. So let's say, for an example, I don't necessarily care much for this at all. Hold on. I can actually change it. And I can actually switch it to, let's say for an example, let's see. I have lots of choices. No, not that one. Let's say for an example, I got a lot of examples, by the way. There we go. Just something like this. Ghost in the woods. Kind of a thing. You can kind of see the point of what I can do with PaintShop Pro. I can even go through as far as, let's say, for example, cut this out. This woman completely out of the image and put her in somewhere else. Okay. I have the ability because I have the lasso tool, which makes freehand selections. So, as you can see here, here's a good example of that. And so you can lasso out all them parts of it and then incorporate that into something else. Now, I've never done it. I probably in the future will. But like I said, I mean, this is something that I would use this for, let's say, for example, books. And I have this now, thanks to somebody who took the time and helped me get this. And like I said, I mean, I'm screwing around with this thing to find the right materials. I love this font, by the way. If you're really wondering, I love this font. This is really one of the coolest fonts I have. I love that font. I'm probably going to be using that. Let's save. And let's export it. Now, I am going to we're going to use this as my thing on the channel to show you how I made this. And it's going to say how I made this in Photoshop. All right. Thank you for watching. And of course, have a nice day. Bye.